sa lupa ang adlaw, kagitgit kauban ang langgami baton, ilang higdaanan tapos na ang buhat, makapahulay pasalamat.
The Lord is risen. He is risen indeed. Praise God. This is another opportunity for us to once again gather together to worship God in spirit and in truth virtually. But we thank the Lord for this powerful opportunity for us not only to listen to His words, but to ask the Lord to give us the desire to put these words into action. I'd like to encourage everyone to include in your prayers, of course, those whom God has blessed for another year in their lives. The birthday celebrators, praying to God that God will continue to bless them and encourage them to face the challenges ahead. And of course, for those who are celebrating their wedding anniversaries, thank the Lord for how God has given you another opportunity to live together as husband and wife, and for how God has blessed you with His love so that you are able to love each other and expand this love to the members of the family and include those who are in need of your love and care. We'd like to encourage you to please include in your prayers the Otor family. As you all know, or for those of you who do not know, at one time in the life and ministry of UCCP Davao City, we had an associate pastor in the person of Reverend Luther Otor Sr. He passed on to another life. Praise God for the life of service that he has rendered to the Lord. He is 80 years old. His remains were interred or were cremated this week. Let us pray for comfort for the Otor family. Let us now offer our lives to God as we gather together to worship God in spirit and in truth.
Happy Resurrection Day, everyone. Welcome to our midweek service. Matthew 28, verse 6 says, "He is not here. He has risen just as He said. Come and see the place where He lay." Tonight, join. Come on and celebrate the resurrection of the Lord. Jesus is alive.
Alleluia. Jesus is alive. Death has lost its victory, and the grave has been denied. Jesus lives forever. Is he. The curse of sin is broken. We have perfect liberty. The Lamb of God is risen. He's alive. He's alive. Hallelujah. Jesus is alive. Death has lost his victory, and the grave has been denied. Jesus lives forever. He's alive. He's alive. He's the Alpha and Omega. The first and last is He. The curse of sin is broken. We have perfect liberty. The Son of God has risen. He's alive.
Yes, Lord, we celebrate your goodness tonight. Come on.
Forevermore, He is risen. He is and celebrate. Come on and celebrate the resurrection of our Lord.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, because you live, we also will live. Your resurrection makes it possible for you to live in our hearts and be a part in our daily living. Thank you that we can live in joyous confidence that the living, victorious Christ is guiding our lives. Help us to respond by walking daily with you, being obedient to you, being aware of your life-giving favor. Yes, we joyously anticipate the day when we will join the heavenly chorus, extolling the one who alone is worthy to be praised. Yes, because Jesus lives, all fear is gone. He holds our future, and that is why life is worth living for. Happy Easter, everyone. Amen and amen.
The basis for our meditation this evening is taken from the Gospel of Jesus according to John, chapter 20, verse 18 to verse 22. In reverence to his words, I would like to request those who are able to please stand. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the disciples were together with the doors locked for fear of the Jewish leaders, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and side. The disciples were overjoyed when they saw the Lord. Again, Jesus said, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you." And with that, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit." This is the word of the Lord. Let us pray. Gracious God, we pray that you speak to our hearts as we listen to your words. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Friends, our meditation for this evening is based on the lectionary reading for this coming Sunday. And since your pastors are preparing another series of sermons, I would like to inform you that please continue to read the lectionary readings. You can Google it on Sunday after Sunday so that you can participate in the entire Christian world where they reflect on a particular passage in the scripture and meditate on this passage. And please encourage yourself to ask the Lord to help you, of course, respond to whatever God would want you to do through the scripture passage that you meditate on. One of the things that the Lord deals with the disciple is their attitude towards how Jesus Christ would want them to be witnesses, to be Christ's disciples, followers of telling others about who he is and about what he has done. In this particular story, you will notice once again how Jesus Christ would want his disciples to behave as followers or believers and followers of Jesus Christ. Now, this time, we know that the disciples did not have any idea at all what is going on, even if they already have heard about Jesus Christ having been resurrected from the grave, but things are not really that clear for them yet. And some of them were afraid of the Jewish leaders because they being followers of Jesus, for certain, they will also go after them. And so, understandably, they had to hide behind locked doors. They locked themselves up, and according to the scriptures, it is because of their fears of the Jewish leaders. However, in this particular condition of the disciples having this fear, that the Jesus that they knew, the one who raised from the grave, appeared before them, showed himself before them, and showed no less than his hands and his side to remind them that no locked doors can stop Jesus from coming to them, to show to them that no death can stop him from rising from the grave, to continue to tell them of what they're supposed to do. First, to let them know that whatever it is that they're afraid of, the Lord is there to remind them that he will never leave them nor forsake them. Now, I know that there are a lot of reasons why we are afraid. One of them perhaps is COVID-19. But afraid in relation to your being a follower of Jesus Christ. And if that comes into your mind and into your heart, friends, remind yourself that Jesus, who came into the disciples at the time when they were afraid of the Jewish leaders, who came into the disciples at the time when they just experienced the horrible death of Jesus Christ on the cross, at the time when they were probably confused of what is happening, Christ's presence is there. And that is very important. The Lord will never leave you nor forsake you, especially in times when you're confused, when you're afraid, when you do not know what to do in relation to your being a follower of Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ will always be there to lead you so that you will continue to follow him. That is important. That is why Jesus Christ in this particular story would want to let the disciples know that, hey, I am still here. I have not left you at all. The second lesson that they have learned in that particular story is that in the midst of fear, in the midst of troubles, in the midst of their confusion, Jesus Christ gave them no less than his presence, but his peace. Because as he appeared before them, he said, "Peace be with you." This is a customary greeting, of course. But Jesus Christ repeated these greetings twice. He said again, "Peace be with you." Isn't it giving you a hint that the Lord's peace is right there when you are confused, when you're troubled, when you're in distress, when you are in fear of whatever? The Lord's peace is there and he will give it to you. Remember what the Lord God said, or what the scripture says: "Do not worry about anything, but in everything by prayer and petition." But in everything, continue to connect to God, continue to speak to the Lord, continue to relate to him in prayer with thanksgiving. And what the scripture says: "And the peace of God, which passes beyond your understanding, will guard not only your heart, but also your mind in Christ Jesus." His peace is right there. Peace is not felt in the absence of war, in the absence of fear, in the absence of chaos, in the absence of confusion. Peace is experienced in the very presence of God, in his very word of assurance. Peace be with you. And finally, whenever you are confused, whenever you are in distress, whenever you are in trouble in relation to your being a disciple, the Lord will always remind you, hey, you don't need to stay behind locked doors. Hey, you don't need to stay in a state of fear and confusion. Hey, you don't need to stay away from what you are supposed to or intended to do as followers of Jesus Christ. Why? Because just as the Father has sent me, Jesus Christ is saying to them, just as the Father has sent me, I am sending you. This is the very work that you are supposed to do. You are sent. You are not asked to just sit in the pews. You are not just called by Jesus Christ to stay. Of course, stay at home. stay home to keep you safe and secure from COVID-19. But your being a disciple should be able to let you go to where God would want you to go, whether you are to go physically or to go through your text messages, through your Facebook pages, shoutouts, and cover page, whatever it is. Give your time to respond to the very basic command of Jesus Christ. You know, as he said, just as the Father has sent me, this is the reason why the Lord, my Father has sent me, because I am now going to send you. Sending us is what makes us his disciples, his followers, because that is basic requirement of being a disciple. You're not just a learner, you're not just a follower. You are actually a doer of his word, because the very words that Jesus Christ left for us to do is to go, not to stay, but to go and make disciples. Go and make disciples. So ask yourselves, in what you are doing right now, is this related to, or am I able to enhance the very work that Jesus Christ would want me to do, and that is to go and make disciples? Wow, praise the Lord. And then you would say, Pastor, that is a tall order. Of course it is. And that is the reason why the very next words that Jesus Christ said, after saying, just as the Father has sent me, I am sending you. You know, what is this line that he said? Then he breathed on them and said, you know what he said? Receive the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit. You know why? Because the word, the work is so enormous. The work is so difficult. The work, of course, entails no less than or demands no less than your very own lives. Going out doesn't only mean exposing yourselves to COVID-19. Going out means actually exposing yourselves from what the world would tell you to do. Please stop. I don't like it. The people will hate for what you are doing. But friends, if you do follow Jesus Christ and respond to his command to go and make disciples, it may even result to giving up your life, just as what the early Christians have done. They were burned at stake. The lions were fed into the lion's den. But lo and behold, no matter how difficult this task may be, because of what the Lord said, Jesus Christ said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. And sure enough, because of what they received, no less than the Holy Spirit, they were empowered, emboldened, encouraged to continue the task given to them as disciples, or people making others Christ followers. Do not be afraid, not only because his presence is there. Do not be afraid, not because his peace is there. Do not be afraid also, and certainly because, and mainly because, the Holy Spirit is there. He is able to give you the strength that you need. He is able to give you the courage that you need, so that no matter what the cost may be, you will continue to make disciples. You will continue to respond to the call of Jesus, sending you just as God the Father has sent him. Make this resurrection resolution for your life, that from now on, I will never be afraid, for the Lord Jesus Christ is with me. From now on, I will respond to the call or the challenge of Jesus. I would want to say, here my Lord, send me. And from now on, I will always let the Holy Spirit give me the courage to do what Jesus Christ would want me to do. For this, I am sure that many would still be able to come to know Jesus Christ as their Savior and Lord because of you. Amen.
lives today. He walks with me and talks with me. The law was not away. He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know he lives. He lives within my heart. In all the world around me, I see his loving care. And though my heart grows weary, I never feel despair. I know that he is leading through all the stormy past. The day of his appearing will come at last. Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know he lives. He lives within my heart. Rejoice, O Christian, lift up your voice and sing. Eternal hallelujahs to Jesus Christ the King. The hope of all who seek me, the help of all who find. None other is so loving, so good and kind. Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know he lives. He lives within my heart.
Thank you so much, dear Lord, for how you have blessed us with the songs, with your word, and with your holy presence through your Holy Spirit. Gracious Lord, we pray that you continue to encourage us to respond to your challenge for us to go and make disciples, reminding us, dear Lord, that we are not doing this alone. We have no less than Jesus Christ's presence with us, and much more the Holy Spirit empowering us, so that we are able to do what God would want us to do in this life as his followers. This we ask in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, do not be afraid, for Jesus Christ's presence is with you. And God would give you his peace beyond all human understanding, the peace that no less than Jesus Christ left to his disciples will also be with you. Friends, remember, just as Jesus Christ sent to us by his Father, we are being sent to go. And as we go, the Holy Spirit is sent for us to empower us and give us the courage to make others Christ followers. As you do all this, go make disciples of all nations. Go and may the blessings of God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you, not only today, but in all the days of your lives. Amen and amen.
Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way.